Hi everyone, it's Lindy. Welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to talk to you a little bit more in depth about making money by selling locally. A question that I've been starting to get more and more frequently is, what exactly do you mean when you say sell things locally? So on my YouTube channel, I do a lot of different liquidation unboxings of things that I'm buying to resell. And sometimes when I am unboxing these items, I will mention selling something locally as opposed to selling things online. And a question I get a lot when I say that is, what exactly I mean when I say the words, I plan to sell this locally. And so that started making me realize that maybe I should do more of an updated video about what it means to sell items local. And if you like videos talking about other ways of selling merchandise, please do give this video a thumbs up. That way I know and I can continue to create specific content like this. Now, selling locally, exactly what is involved, how do you do it, and where do you do it? Now, whenever I sell merchandise locally, I sell it one of two ways. I will sell it either at a yard sale kind of pop-up event where it's just something straight out of my garage when the weather is nice, or I will sell those items on Facebook Marketplace. Now, there are a lot of people that like to use Craigslist for selling locally. I personally don't use Craigslist. After using Facebook Marketplace for so long, Craigslist just feels so much more spammy, and I have so much success with Facebook Marketplace, I really see no reason to try another one. So I just stick with what works. Same thing with the apps like Letgo and OfferUp. I've tried putting a few things on those apps and I've just had zero luck with it. It might just be that my local surrounding area utilizes Facebook more than Letgo or OfferUp, so a lot of them don't really pay attention to those apps. They just pay attention to Facebook. So I would just highly encourage you to maybe try them all and see what local buyers are responding to best. For me, I've tried them all, and Facebook Marketplace is where everybody does their local shopping. First, let's talk about the reasons why you would want to sell something locally as opposed to selling them online. One of the main reasons why I like to flip things locally is because it's significantly faster than selling it online. When you sell items online, you have to take the time to accurately describe the item, you have to take multiple photos, you have to go through the entire listing process, and then you have to sit around and wait for someone to find it and buy it. But when you're selling items locally, usually you can take less pictures and do less of a description because people can just message you if they have a very specific question. And the buyers will most likely buy faster if you're posting it local than online. I find that my fastest flips are local. You can list something online and things can sell within a couple hours, but still, that's not as fast as flipping something local. Let me give you an example of this. I received a liquidation health and beauty lot, and in it was three large bottles of shampoo. I was not even done going through the box. I set those bottles aside. I snapped a picture of it with my phone, posted it to Facebook Marketplace, and within 1 hour, somebody had already come and picked them up and paid me for them. So before I even got done going through the entire box, I already had a buyer for some of the items in it. I had cash in my hand within an hour of opening the box. That kind of stuff don't happen online. If you're listing an item online, you're having to create that listing, you're having to take photographs, you're having to send the listing live, and then you have to wait. So even if somebody were to buy your listing 1 hour after listing it on a platform like eBay, it still would have taken longer for you to get that money than if you just flipped it locally like I did. Another time I might sell something locally as opposed to selling it online is when the cost of shipping doesn't make sense. Like if you have an item that you know a buyer would find value in, but the cost of shipping brings the price up so much it's no longer worth it to the buyer to buy it. Let's just say for argument's sake, this candle. Let's say this candle is worth $10 to a buyer. That buyer would definitely buy this candle for $10. But because of the weight and the fact that it's glass, it's going to cost significant money to ship this safely to a buyer. When you add the cost of shipping into the product, the buyer is no longer wanting to pay that dollar amount for this candle. This candle would have a $10 value to a buyer, but you would have to charge $20 for it just to get that item to the buyer. And at that point, it's no longer worth the money. But you can easily put something like this on Facebook Marketplace and a buyer would snatch it up for $10 and you didn't have to worry about shipping it because it's glass. Also, not to mention, what if this got broken during shipping? Then you would have to be dealing with insurance, you would have to be refunding the buyer, you would have to be dealing with all of the customer service. I'm so sorry that happened. I don't know if I didn't package it properly, yada, yada, yada. But if you're selling this locally, you are just handing the person the item and the transaction is over. There's no customer service needed after the fact. That's another benefit to selling locally. When you exchange the item for the money, the transaction is over. There is no more extended customer service needed. There's also no returns. The buyer can't call you up and be like, "This candle doesn't burn flames big enough. I want my money back." When you sell stuff locally, you're like, tough. It's your candle now. You already paid for it. There's also no platform fees. If you sell an item on Facebook Marketplace, or if you sell it locally at a yard sale, there is no 10% that you have to pay to a platform. So couple that with not having to pay shipping labels, not having to deal with customer service. Selling locally is starting to sound a lot more appealing, isn't it? Now, when it comes to selling locally at garage sales, I have an entire video about that, and I will link that up here in the iCards for you to go watch after this video is done. But the only problem with selling at yard sales or garage sales, whichever one you call them, is that for a lot of people like me, you can't do them year round. If you lived in maybe Florida or California, then you could have a yard sale all year. But here in Kansas, about 6 months out of the year, it is way, way too cold to be having a yard sale. So that's why I need to try to find other ways of selling locally, because I cannot rely 100% on yard sales because of my location. So when you're listing an item for sale on Facebook Marketplace, you also have the ability to cross promote that same item into different Facebook groups. Like, I am personally a member of a lot of local Facebook buy sell trade pages. So when I list an item to Facebook Marketplace, I have the ability to cross promote that same item up to 10 other Facebook groups, which just broadens the range of potential buyers in my local area. And Facebook has really been doing a good job at creating different perks for the marketplace. There's an entirely separate section for messaging back and forth with potential buyers that have found you through the marketplace. There's also ways to go into your listings and easily mark them as sold or pending. And you can even see the notifications specifically related to that item all at one glance. Before, Facebook Marketplace used to be random people would message you about an item and it was really hard to keep track. But now they have really paid attention to all of these finite details that help you sell more on the platform without mixing up people and having issues keeping track of buyers. Facebook has also enacted Facebook Pay, meaning these buyers can negotiate with you over Facebook Messenger, and they can actually send you money through the Messenger app, and that money can be transferred directly into your PayPal account. So that really eliminates the hassle of buyers needing to have cash for transactions. Because if you have something and maybe you ask $7 for it, rather than inconveniencing your buyer to try to come up with a 5 and 2 ones, they can just send you $7 over Facebook Pay and you can just transfer that right into your PayPal account with all of your other transactions. I've personally experienced that that handling that financial transaction through Facebook Pay actually makes the entire process of pickup or drop off a lot more simple. Because what happens is the buyer contacts you and lets you know that they want to purchase the item. If they send the money through Facebook Pay right then and there, the financial part of the transaction is done. Then it's just about coordinating when that buyer gets to get their item. And when the money part is already taken care of, there's no more of this need to meet face to face and have a dialogue. It could be something as simple as, I'll drop it off on your porch when I'm out running errands, or you can pick it up on my porch if I'm not home. It makes the transaction go so much more smoothly when you don't have to worry about coordinating exact pickup times. And I've personally done that. You know, just the other day, I had somebody send me a $20 Facebook Pay. And when I was out running errands, I literally dropped the item off on their covered porch for them. I didn't have to worry about meeting them. I didn't have to worry about coordinating a time. There was none of that like awkwardness, you know, when you meet a stranger for the first time and they're giving you money and you're giving them an item. There's kind of that awkward moment, because a lot of us are introverts. You know, nobody would ever guess that about me. I'm an introverted extrovert, and I don't necessarily like want to see people and be like, give me your money and I'll give you the thingy. I would rather just drop the item off on their doorstep and walk away, never having to see anybody. And being able to accept payments through Facebook Pay allows you to do that, because once the money part is done, it just becomes about, when are you gonna pick up this item on my porch? When am I gonna drop it off in your car? And of course, how you coordinate the drop off and pickup is completely up to you. You know, it's definitely safer if you're going to be meeting with somebody to meet in a public place. It's well lit, lots of people around. There's lots of people that do exchanges at police departments or like a Starbucks parking lot. Or if you're comfortable with having somebody come to your house or you going to their house just to drop it off in the porch like I do, that's completely up to you. I personally don't mind dropping off things at people's houses because I feel like I'm running all over town all the time anyway. So simply bringing an item with me to put it on their porch, that's not a big deal at all. One thing that I do definitely recommend if you're doing a lot of local sales is having a very small notebook like this. And what I would recommend is having one page for every single item that you're selling. And what you would do is you would write the item that you're selling across the top of the page, and then the entire page is filled with people that are interested or who is pending pickup. Because what ends up happening to me all the time is that I will have someone who is interested and they tell me that they're going to come and pick it up at a specific time. And then what ends up happening is after I have basically promise that to one person, and then I get more messages later on of people who are interested. So what'll end up happening is I will tell someone, yes, I will meet you at 6 o'clock after you get off work, but then at 4 o'clock and 5 o'clock, I have people who start messaging me saying, did you sell it yet? Did you sell it yet? And I have to tell those people, no, it's pending pickup for 6 o'clock, but I can let you know if the buyer doesn't buy it, and then you can buy it. And so that's what this notebook would be for. So I would have diapers up here at the top. I would have the person and the time I'm meeting them. And then underneath, I would have the other people that were interested. And then underneath, I would have the other people that were interested in the order of priority. So if I have three more people that are interested, I would number them 1, 2, 3 for who gets first, who gets second, and who gets third dibs. And something like this is a really easy way to keep track of local buyers. I tried doing it without a notebook and it was a disaster. I couldn't keep straight who had second dibs, who had third dibs, how many people said that they were interested that never showed up. It just became extremely frustrating. That's something else that's really nice about Facebook Pay, is because if somebody sends you a payment through Facebook, there's no more of this, oh, I decided I can't come and get it today. Can I get it tomorrow? And then you're sitting around waiting for someone to buy the item and you're missing out on other potential sales because people seem like they're dragging their feet. Like, for instance, I just had somebody send me money through Facebook Pay and we're still trying to coordinate a pickup, but I'm not worried about it because they live the next town over, so it's a little bit more difficult to schedule a pickup, but I'm not worried about it because I already got the money. I don't need to, you know, turn down other people and think, what if they would have paid me sooner? I already have the money for it. Now it's just about coordinating pickup with this person, but I've already been paid, so I'm not worried about it. So when you're selling items locally, not only could you be flipping that item faster, but you could also be getting more money for it because you don't have to worry about shipping charges or platform fees. Selling locally is definitely a default that I do every single week. So over this last week, when we were dealing with a lot of eBay glitches and sales took a nosedive, I just simply redirected my focus and I started selling a lot more stuff locally because I knew that that was a way that I could get instant cash in my pocket and I wasn't even needing to worry about the fact that sales were down on eBay because I had cash in hand or instant Facebook Pay transfers into my PayPal account. And I wasn't having to worry about paying platform fees. I wasn't having to worry about shipping items. I wasn't needing to use up shipping supplies. It was as simple as handing someone a product and being done with the transaction, cash in hand. I actually made more money faster selling locally during all of those eBay glitches than I would have made in profits on eBay. So I would encourage you, if you haven't really thought about selling locally, to give it a try. Maybe sell 5 items a week locally. See how local buyers respond. See if your profits are better with local sales than selling online, because sometimes that can happen. When you take out the costs that you have to pay when it comes to selling online, sometimes it's better just to sell to somebody locally through Facebook Marketplace, but you don't know that until you try it and crunch the numbers. And I sell all different kinds of items locally. I've sold clothing locally. I've sold nail polish locally. I've sold lipstick and mascara locally. I've sold vitamins. I've sold hair care. I've sold personal care items like shampoo and body wash and bar soap. I've sold shaving cream locally. I've sold diapers, wipes, baby onesies, candles, books, hairbrushes, calendars, furniture. You want to ship a piece of furniture? I don't think so. These that I just recently got in a haul that I posted to my channel this last week. These I'm probably gonna sell locally because I kinda sorta don't feel like shipping this giant tube. But it's an at-a-glance calendar. I know that local buyers would buy this. And because it's inconvenient to ship it, I really don't feel like shipping it. So I'll just sell it local, make some quick money. The whole point is to be open-minded with how to sell merchandise. Even if you're selling something for $5, it's probably going to be worth it to flip it quick and get your capital back and have cash in hand, rather than taking the time to list it and waiting for it to sell. Selling items locally is also a way for you to earn capital for growing an online business. Let's say you're in the beginning stages of a reselling business and you really want to have an Amazon store or an eBay store, but capital is really tight. Something that you can easily do is go around your house and find items that you are no longer using, sell them locally over Facebook Marketplace or a yard sale, and use that money to fund your reselling business. That's something that I recommend people do all the time. If you have very little capital and you don't really have the money that you can pull out of your bank account to invest in a liquidation lot or going to the thrift stores and buying things, you can sell items out of your own house on Facebook Marketplace and use that as your launch pad to funding your financial future. Yard sales have honestly been so successful for me that I have been increasing the amount that I sell locally every single week, because when the results are there, you can't deny it. You have to put your energy where the money is. And there is definitely money in local sales. I'm hoping that this video gave you some insight, gave you some more ideas for moving merchandise locally, if it's not selling online very well. That's something else that you could do. If something is maybe not selling very quickly and you're needing to get some of that capital back, pull it off of eBay or whatever platform you're selling it on and try selling it locally. That's a good way to get that capital back in your pocket and get the cash flow back into your business. If maybe you made a bad buy, you weren't expecting something to sit so long, trying to flip it locally is a really nice way to get that money back quick. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video and videos like it, please give it a thumbs up. That way I know. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them down in the comments below. Do you like to sell locally? If you do, what is your favorite platform to sell on? I'm always curious to see if there's other platforms that I have not tried yet that's out there that I've never heard of. Put them down in the comments below. Let me know what kind of local sales you are doing. Do not forget to check the video description. I will put some useful links in there. And please do remember to subscribe if you're interested in seeing more content. And I'll see you guys with my next video. Bye-bye.